Hello everyone, I Kaneera Chirag, Faculty of Diploma Computer in Dr. Subhash Technical Campus. Welcome to Lecture 3 of Unit 1, Introduction to Mobile Computing. Today we discuss some topics of Introduction to Mobile Computing. First, noise and its type, how affect noise in mobile computing, basic of GSM, basic of CDMA technology, and difference between GSM and CDMA. Noise refer to any energy interference that degrade the quality of a wireless signal. Noise is any undesired signal in a communication circuit that degrades the quality of signal and data. Noise occurs in digital and analog system and can affect file and communication of all types, including text, program, image, audio, and telemetry. There are various of noise, however the four most important to the telecommunication are thermal noise, intermodulation noise, crosstalk, and impulse noise. First, thermal noise. Thermal noise occurs in all transmission media and communication equipment. Every equipment element and the transmission medium itself contribute thermal noise. If the temperature of that element or medium is above absolute zero, the more heat generated or applied, the greater the level of thermal noise. Second, intermodulation noise. Intermodulation noise is the result of presence of intermodulation products. If two signals of frequency F1 and F2 are passed through a non-linear device or medium, the result will contain IM product, means intermodulation products. The products results when two or more signal mixed together. Crosstalk, disturbance caused by electric and magnetic field of one communication signal affecting a signal in nearby circuit. In telephone circuit, crosstalk results in hearing from another circuit. In wireless communication, crosstalk results in channel interference. And last, impulse noise. It includes unwanted sharp sound caused by electromagnetic interference, scratches on disk, voltage changes in agents. So these are the four types of noise can affect wireless signal in mobile computing. Next topic is GSM. GSM and CDMA are shorthand for the two major radio system used in cell phone. These two technology differ in way calls and data travel over the mobile phone network take place. GSM stands for Global System for Mobile Communication. It is a digital cellular technology used for transmitting mobile voice and data services. GSM phone make use of SIM card to identify the user's account. The use of SIM card allows GSM network user to quickly move their phone number from one SIM phone to another by simply moving the SIM card. Frequency band in GSM. The frequency range specified for GSM is 1850 to 1990 MHz. Duplex distance. Duplex distance is 80 MHz. Duplex distance is the distance between the uplink and downlink frequency. A channel has two frequency, 80 MHz apart. Channel separation in GSM. The separation between adjacent carrier frequency is 200 kHz. Modulation is the process of sending a signal by changing the characteristics of a carrier frequency. This is done in GSM via Gaussian minimum shift keying. Transmission rate in GSM is a digital system with an over-the-air bit rate of 270 kbps. Access method. GSM utilizes the time division multiple access, means TDMA concept. TDMA is a technique in which several different calls may share the same carrier. Each call is assigned a particular time slot. So this is the basic of GSM technology. Next, CDMA. CDMA stands for code division multiple access. CDMA uses spread spectrum techniques because of its security and resistance of jamming. As the term implies, CDMA is a form of multiplexing which allows numerous signals to occupy a single transmission channel, optimizing the use of available bandwidth. CDMA can effectively reject narrowband interference since narrowband interference affects only a small portion of the spread spectrum signal. It can easily be removed through notch filtering without much of loss of information. In a CDMA system, the same frequency can be used in every cell because channelization is done using the pseudo random codes. Reusing the same frequency in every cell eliminates the need for the frequency blending in a CDMA system. CDMA system uses the soft handoff, which is undetachable and provide a more reliable and higher quality signal. CDMA consistently provide a better capacity for voice and data communication, allowing more subscribers to connect at any given time. CDMA is the common platform on which 3G technology are built. So this is the basic concept of CDMA. Difference between GSM CDMA. First factor is full form. CDMA stands for code division multiple access. GSM stands for global system mobile communication. Second factor, storage type. CDMA use internal memory for storage. GSM use SIM card for storage. Global share. CDMA share 25%, GSM say 75%. Data transfer rate in CDMA use EVDO 3G 4G LTE. GSM use GPRS 3G 4G LTE. International roaming. For CDMA less accessible, GSM more accessible. Frequency band in CDMA single, which is 850 MHz. In GSM more than 1850 900 1800 1900 MHz. Network service in CDMA handset specific, in GSM SIM specific. Thank you for watching lecture of unit 1 introduction to mobile computing. For more video, like our college YouTube channel and share and subscribe. Thank you.